there. Oh, I am so excited. It's the annual Pop Paper City Garden Design Competition, and you never guess who won. Zip! Yes, Zip's garden design won. So he'll be given an award later today at the grand opening of his garden. Oh, and you should see it. It's unbelievable.
Perfect. The centerpiece looks just like my design.
Wow, your garden looks amazing. Especially the centerpiece. Those flowers are beautiful.
Phoebe helped me plant them. And look, to say thank you, I promised I would grow an extra one just for her. Ooh, I should take it to her before the grand opening. Hello, Plom. Are you okay?
Hi, Zip. Yes. I'm just practicing for later when I pass my garden design award on to you. Ooh, that's a beautiful flower.
Oh, it's to say thank you.
Aw, you didn't have to. Passing on the garden design award is all part of my duty as last year's winner. Now, where shall I put you? Sorry, what was that, Zip?
Nothing.
Oh, okay. See you at the grand opening.
Oh, now what do I do?
Oh, hey, Zip. Did Phoebe like her flower? Oh, I bet she did. She loves flowers.
Oh, I haven't given it to her yet.
You'd better hurry then. You need to be back for your grand opening. Right, now to get the lanterns.
Oh, I need another thank you flower and quick. But where? I'm sure one flower won't make a difference.
Hi, Plom. Have you got the award for Zip?
Yep, it's in my super safe place over there.
Huh?
I mean my super safe place over there.
Nope.
I mean there. No, there.
Plom, have you forgotten where your super safe place is?
Yeah.
Don't worry, we'll help you look for it.
Oh, there she is. Phoebe, here's the flower I promised you. Thank you for helping me with my garden.
It's so beautiful. Wow, I bet the centerpiece looks amazing with all the flowers together.
Oh, yes, I just remembered I need to go and check on something. See you later. No, the gap's too big. Oh, now they look too squished. Okay, let's just clear the space and start again. The first flower goes here. Or maybe here?
Nope, no sign of the award.
Oh, hey, Phoebe. Any luck?
No, I can't find it anywhere. But I did get this flower from Zip. Isn't it beautiful?
Yeah, it's amazing.
Oh, look! There are more!
I wonder if Zip would let us have one.
Hey, Zip, are these flowers spare?
Well, we have one too.
You must be so excited, Zip.
Yes.
We can have them? Wow!
Thank you, Zip!
Oh no, I meant...
You've all got flowers too! Zip, that's so nice of you.
My pleasure.
Come on, let's leave Zip to prepare for the grand opening. We'll absolutely, definitely pass on that award.
That I still can't find.
Ah, my centerpiece!
Not long to go now, Zip. Now to get ready and be back for the grand opening.
Oh, this doesn't match my design at all. There's only one thing for it. I'll have to create a brand new centerpiece.
Ugh! Yeah, let's get arty!
No!
Plom, we've looked everywhere. We can't find the award.
And it's time to go.
I can't go to Zip's grand opening without the award. Come on, Plom, think. Where could your super safe place be? Huh? Oh! That's where I put it. It wasn't in my super special safe place. It was in my super spectacular special safe place.
Oh, Plom!
Come on, we'd better go.
I can't wait to see what Zip's done.
It's almost time for the big opening. There must be something I can do.
Zip, what happened? Where are all your lovely flowers?
I don't think I can say.
Why can't he tell us? We're his friends.
No matter what it is, I'm sure it's not as bad as he thinks.
I only had one spare flower for Phoebe. Plom thought it was for him. All the other flowers were for my centerpiece. I didn't want to upset you, so I let you have them. But I should have said no.
Oh, no! Poor Zip!
Sorry for taking your flowers, Zip. You should have said. We would have understood.
In that case, can I have my flowers back, please? Then I can fix my display.
Of course. We'll go and get them. And you can have the extra flower that you grew for me to replace the one that got crushed.
Thank you for bringing the flowers. But even with Phoebe's flower, you can still see the big muddy patch.
What if we make an ice sculpture to hide it?
No, it would melt in the sun.
We could plant more flowers.
No, they'll take too long to grow. And the ground's too wet.
Some flowers like wet ground.
Yes, like the lotus. Helping hand! Will you help us make a lotus flower, please?
Of course. Get set. Ready to make.
3, 2, 1, let's get crafty!
That's everything we need. First, we fold. Now for the petals and leaves. Let's put them all together. And with a pop, we're ready to go.
It's not the same as my design. It's even more beautiful.
Hooray!
Yay!
It is beautiful!
Yeah!
I declare Zip's winning garden open!
Hooray!
Thank you, everyone. Now, no touching my flowers.
Wow! Zip's garden ended up more beautiful than ever. Come on, loat us take a stroll. Loat us. Sorry, I can't help it. See you all soon. Oh, wait! Don't leaf me! there, folks. Thanks for tuning in to Pop Paper City Radio. I've got some exciting news. Mae-Mae asked me to help build a surprise for her and her friends. And now it's time to hand over to Mae-Mae for the big reveal.
Ta-da! So, what do you think?
What exactly is it?
It's a bandstand. You know, an outdoor stage that's covered so that bands can play no matter what the weather is. And I'm going to be the first person to sing on it.
Go, Mae-Mae!
Yeah. I've always wanted to sing on stage, but I can't do it alone. So I was hoping that you would be my band.
Wow!
Zip, zip, zippity! Playing in a band would be amazing.
And I have one more surprise. To celebrate our new bandstand, I'd like you to perform live on my Pop Paper City radio show this evening.
Wow! Not only do I get to sing on stage, but I go to be on the radio!
Not just any radio, Pop Paper City radio. Oh, I think we need to practice and quick.
Right, practice. Let's go. Okay, these are the instruments I want everybody to play.
Oh, thanks.
Oh,
thanks. And wow. Now to zip. I have something really special for you.
Ooh.
Oh, I want you to write the words to our song because you're so good at writing stories and poems.
Oh, sure. But I...
Poptastic! You start writing and we'll get practicing.
Wait, we need a band name.
I hadn't thought of that.
How about Pop Club?
Yes, we're Pop Club. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pop Club 5. Come on.
Home.
Listen up, Pop Club 5. I'm going to sing, and when I point at you, I want you to play along. Ready? La 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 la.
Oh, I think you need a microphone.
Sorry, Zip, I can't hear you over the band. I can hardly hear me.
Was that not the note you wanted?
Not even close.
I don't think Fly could hear you. None of us could.
You couldn't hear me. I couldn't hear me. So how is anyone else going to hear me when we play on the radio?
I was just trying to say you need a microphone.
Yes, you need a microphone.
Yes, a microphone. Great idea, Plom.
Huh?
Sorry, Zip. I can't think about the words for the song right now. Come on, band. We've got a microphone to make.
The band? That's definitely not me.
Helping hand! Can you help us make a microphone, please?
A microphone? Sure. Get set. Ready to make.
3, 2, 1, let's get crafty!
This is everything we need to make a microphone.
This will work as a base.
Now we need to make the head of the microphone.
Let's stick it together.
And with a pop, we're ready to go.
Testing. 1, 2, 3.
Whoa! We can definitely hear you now.
Yes! We'll be ready for the radio in no time.
But what about the words to the song?
Yes, of course! Zip!
Where's he gone?
Okay, you go and practice and I'll go and find him.
There you are, Zip. Why did you leave?
Well, actually, I was feeling left out.
Are those the words for the song? Is that fly playing another flat note?
About playing note, do you think I could be in the band?
We can't play on the radio with flat notes. Supposed to play da 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 at the end.
Mae-Mae, you forgot the song words.
Oh, right. Thanks, Zip. Okay, band, let's put it all together. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
We're all friends making music together. We're all friends, whatever the weather.
No, Mae-Mae, not like that.
Wait, stop. The words don't fit our tune.
Yes, they do. It goes like this.
We're all friends making music.
Right, Mae-Mae. It's time to get you and your band to the bandstand. My radio show's about to begin.
Quick, let's try again.
We're all friends.
This isn't working.
Let me show you.
No. Zip, there's no time. Me and the band have to practice. Oh. Zip! Zip! I'm sorry! Zip!
Mae-Mae, we have to go.
You go. Play without me. I need to find Zip.
There you are, Zip. I'm sorry I got cross and shouted.
What were you trying to say?
Which time?
Huh?
I tried to tell you that you needed a microphone. I asked to be in the band. And then I tried to teach you how to sing the words.
Sorry. Again. I was so busy thinking about my dream, I didn't think about you.
But Mae-Mae, aren't you supposed to be singing on the radio?
I didn't go. I was too worried about you. And besides, I didn't learn your words in time.
You just weren't singing them the right way.
Maybe you can show me how.
Yes.
And quick!
Hey there, listeners! We're kicking off tonight's show, celebrating our new bandstand with a cool new band!
I guess we're Pop Club 4 now.
Make that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6! Pop Club 6! Together?
Together!
We're all friends making music together. We're all friends, whatever the weather. Making music and singing in a band. We're the band for the new bandstand.
You did it, Fly! Thank you, Pop Club 6. And thank you, Zip, for being the best bandmates ever!
Hooray! We did it together!
There you have it, folks! Here on Pop Paper City Radio, we make dreams come true. Now, how about an encore?
Oh, Fly!
Stretch.
One, two, three.
Hi there. Mae-Mae's asked everyone to meet her in their best sports gear. She's got something very sporty planned. I wonder what it is.
Wow, what is all this, Mae-Mae?
Well, Phoebe, we're going to have a Pop Paper City Sports Day.
Oh, yay!
Yeah! I'm going to be the Sports Day judge. The winner of each event will win a star. The person with the most stars at the end is the champion!
Yay!
Yay!
Hooray! I want to win a prize!
Wait, there's a prize? That prize is mine.
Oh, a prize.
Yes. I'll just go and get it.
How could I forget to bring a prize?
And the prize cup goes to Hooper!
Hooper!
Hooray!
Hooper!
Oh, yay! I need a good prize.
You get warmed up. I'll be right back.
Prize. Prize. What could make a prize?
Wow. That's it. Helping hand.
Oh, hi, Mae-Mae.
Can you help me make a big, beautiful prize rosette? And quickly, please.
Of course. On your marks. Get set. Ready to make.
3, 2, 1. Let's get crafty.
One super sporty prize rosette coming right up.
Wait, I haven't warmed up properly. Let me stretch it out.
Talking of stretching, it's time to stretch out our rectangle. Now, let's make the base of our rosette. Next, stick the circles to the base. If only there were a prize for the gluing champ. And with a pop, we're ready to go.
The champion of the Pop Paper City Sports Day will win. Fly, drum roll, please. Ta-da!
Wow!
Wow!
Wow, come on! Let's get this Sports Day started! I really want to win that rosette.
Okay, let the games begin! The first event is... the Egg and Spoon Race! Competitors are ready!
Yes!
Ready!
So ready!
Come on!
The first one to cross the finish line with their egg wins! On your marks, get set!
No!
Not today, egg!
Fly, don't celebrate. You haven't won yet.
Careful.
Sorry, Fly, you dropped your egg. You're out.
Come on, come on.
Come on, Phoebe. You can do this.
No.
Come on, Phoebe.
Judge. I declare that the winner of the Egg and Spoon Race is... Phoebe!
Yes!
Now for our next event.
Well done, Phoebe. I'm not very good at balancing, so I was really pleased when I thought I'd won. Never mind.
Aw, poor Plom. Well, he was a very close second.
Huh? Where's Plom got a star? I thought Phoebe won.
I guess I could give out more than one star. But Phoebe did actually win. Event to the great welly throw! The furthest throw wins!
My welly went the furthest.
Wow, look how far mine's gone.
Mine went the highest, so surely that's the furthest.
I'm not sure how you judge that.
Huh?
Don't worry, I've got the scores all under control.
Okay,
Plom's looks the furthest,
but his welly isn't in the field.
Zip's definitely is, but then Hooper's welly went really high. High can be far.
Oh, but now look, Fly hasn't got a star.
They did all do well.
I hope the last event is easier to judge.
Right, okay, here goes. The wheelbarrow race winners are...
Go! Go!
Fly! You're doing it again! You shouldn't celebrate until we know who's won!
Yeah, me and Hooper won! Yes!
Huh?
I think we won.
We were still in our wheelbarrow when we crossed the line. Surely we won.
But I was first past the line.
Does that mean Phoebe just gets a star?
Or do me and Fly get a star too?
And what does that do to the final score?
You'll have to wait and see. Just sorting the scores out now.
Who do you think's going to win?
Me, of course.
Phoebe crossed the line first. Zip and Fly were in her team.
But Plom and Hooper stayed in their wheelbarrow.
Oh, but they were all amazing. I don't know who the champion is. Sorry.
Why are there so many stars?
I'm so confused.
I saw you looking sad, Plom, and I wanted to give you a star too. And then I didn't think about the welly rules properly. So I tried to be fair to everyone because I didn't want to hurt anyone's feelings. And then I just kept giving out stars.
Aww.
Aww, that was so nice, Mae-Mae. But today's been so much fun. We'll cheer whoever the champion is.
Absolutely!
Yes, that's right!
Then I better work out who that champion is. Leave it to me. The Sports Day champion is... Plom!
Hooray!
Hooray! Hooray!
Plom's the champion!
Plom! Thanks, Mae-Mae.
But you are all great competitors. So I asked Helping Hand for a favour.
And these are for the runners-up.
Wow!
Thank you.
Wow!
It's okay this time, Fly.
Now you can celebrate.
Oh, I really want a rosette now. Hey, how about one last event?
Oh, you guys. I declare that the winners are my best friends.
They were just too strong. One day I'll get a rosette, but I think I just need a bit more training. Wow, what a fantastic sporty day. Bye, champs. Hello, what an exciting day. Hooper has organised his first ever day out for his friends. Oh, shall we find out where they're going? That's a big clue. Shall we find out?
Woohoo! I'm all set for our big day at the beach.
Hooray!
I've got games, a picnic. I've even got sunblock.
Wow! You thought of everything, Hooper. But where are the others?
Phoebe said they'll catch us up. Come on. Da-da-da-da! To the beach!
Phoebe, hasn't Hooper packed already?
Yes. But it's his first time being in charge of a day out. So, I've brought a few bits and bobs. In case he needs them.
Whoa. Whoa. Oh.
Probably best if I just pull it.
Hooper, why am I under an umbrella on such a sunny day?
It's called a parasol. It keeps the hot sun from shining on you.
A parasol! I love it!
Looks like rain's coming, Fly.
It's okay, I can do this.
I'll just make sure all our beach run is done and we're home before it gets here.
I've brought a few bits to help out.
My parasol.
I'm sorry. Let me fix it.
Woohoo!
Yeah, let's fix it.
No, it's fine. Just leave it. We need to start playing the game. Come on.
Hooper's big day out can only get better.
Okay, teams. On the beach, I've hidden two golden seashells. Handmade and decorated by me. Each team must find their seashell to move on to the next round. Ready? Find your golden shell!
Oh, great! Let's go!
Plom! Fly! I found a golden seashell!
Oh no! We need that shell so we can move on to the next round!
Oh, Hooper's game!
Oh, Dom! It's okay!
I'll get it!
No, Phoebe, it's fine!
Don't worry, I won't let anything else go wrong! Seashell! Where are you?
Hurry back, Phoebe!
Coming!
Come on!
Phoebe! Come on! Phoebe! We need you!
Got it!
You've got spare seashells?
Of course! I did try to tell you,
but we couldn't carry on because we were supposed to be in a team.
Well, I'm here now, Mae-Mae. So let's play!
Sorry, everyone. There's no time. But it is time for our picnic.
Hooray! Oh, I love picnics!
I was really looking forward to seeing what the next round was.
Oh, well.
Ooh, careful, Hooper!
That basket doesn't look safe. There! It will be much easier with a table. Oh, what?
Phoebe!
Oh, sorry. Your basket was all wobbly. I thought you could put it on the table.
Oh, it was fine on the rock. I checked. Oh, no! Quick, Fly! Stop that napkin! All the food and drink are covered in sand.
We can't eat that now. I was just trying to help.
Oh,
Oh, come on, Hooper. Your day can still be fun.
Roll up! Roll up! For Hooper's next activity! Go, Hooper!
We can do this, if we're quick.
Thanks, Phoebe! Come on, everyone! It's time to build a really big sandcastle as fast as we can!
Okay! Yay! Yeah! Let's go!
Yay!
Yes! Hooper's big day out is finally going to plan! No! Our sandcastle is all wonky. We need to make it stronger so it doesn't crumble. If we add some water, that will help it stick together.
Phoebe, wonky is fine. Let's just make it as fast as we can.
Don't worry. I've got a bucket in my bag. I'll sort it. Seashells and put the picnic basket on the flat rock. I'm sorry, Hooper. I should have believed in you. But instead, I ruined everything, including your parasol, which now, we need.
Quick! Let's run home!
We can't. It's too far and we'll get soaking wet.
But look! We could shelter under that tree.
We can't stay here. I'm still getting wet.
And so's all our stuff.
That's it! We need something with a roof. Helping hand? We'd like to make a beach hut, please.
Sure thing, Hooper. Get set. Ready to make? 3, 2, 1.
Let's get crafty!
This is everything we need to make a beach hut. Ready? Let's start with the walls. Brilliant folding lines, you two. These will be the doors.
Now it's time to decorate it.
Time to stick it all together. Finally, the roof. And with a pop, we're ready to go.
We're cozy and dry. All thanks to Hooper's idea.
But all our stuff's still outside. Oh, new game. Who can get everything back quickest? Aha! And now for some snacks. I brought them just in case.
Hooper, you really did think of everything.
Yes! The rain stopped! We can make my big sandcastle after all!
Nice and wonky, please.
Oh, what a lovely big sandcastle and a brilliant big day out. Well done, Hooper. You know, you really did think of everything. Hello there. It's a summery day and we're hitting the beach. Oh, and look, there's a big beach surprise.
What's the surprise, Plom?
Yes, Plom, what is it?
It's
a big mysterious ball.
No, ice pops. I made them for our day out at the beach.
No, look, here. It's beautiful. I wonder what it is.
Hello, my precious.
Something so shimmery shouldn't be out here. I'll take it home and keep it safe on my bedroom table. Whoa! No! Don't worry, my precious. I'll save you. That beastie took my shimmery shiny and gobbled it.
Don't worry, Mae-Mae. We'll get it back. We can train a crab to plunge into the ocean and fetch it.
Nip, nop, nip, nop, nip, nop. Yes, that's it.
Great. I'll find a crab.
No, not a crab. But you know what else plunges into the ocean and can take us to the shimmery shiny? A submarine!
Aye, aye, Captain Mae-Mae!
Oh, okay. I guess I'll just put my icebox back then.
Helping hand! Could you help us make a submarine, please?
On the double, lots of bubbles. Get set, ready to make.
3, 2, 1, let's get crafty!
This is what we need to make a submarine. Dive in, everyone. Now we poke a hole into our submarine. You'll see why soon. Next, we make the propeller. First, we cut.
Unfold. There, a periscope to peek through.
That's what the hole is for.
Now for the windows, so we'll be able to spot my shimmery shiny.
And with a pop, we're ready to go.
This is your captain speaking. The underwater rescue mission is ready to launch.
Mae-Mae, about my ice pops.
Don't worry, Plom. We'll be back to taste your delicious ice pops.
Before they melt?
Before they melt, I promise. So come on, crew. The greedy gobbler can't have got too far.
Hooray!
Ready for descent in 3, 2, 1.
Operation Find My Shimmery Shiny is a go!
You heard our captain. All eyes on deck.
It's okay, crew. You don't need to keep watch. I have a periscope. As your captain, I can do it.
But I thought we were helping find the shimmery shiny.
If Mae-Mae's doing all the watching,
what do we do?
How about a guided tour?
Yeah!
Really?
Yeah!
Welcome. I'm Phoebe. I'm here to guide you through the ocean.
There's something on my radar. It's the shimmery shiny. Don't worry, my precious. I'm here to save you.
To your right, that little fish is the purple-spotted...
Funny name for a fish. Nice to meet you, purple-spotted. Whoa!
You're not getting away that easy! Ha! Gotcha! Now drop it. Oh, no! Mission hiccup! Well, that's not going to stop me, beastie.
Actually, Mae-Mae, I've
think it's called a giant. Down to your left, you can see beautiful coral. And in it is something shimmery and shiny.
Shimmery, shiny? It's okay. Captain Mae-Mae's here. Careful of the coral, Mae-Mae.
Yes! I got you!
It looks quite dark in there. Maybe we should leave. You know, get back to my delicious ice pops before they melt.
The beastie's back! Brace yourselves, everyone!
Sure, we should be going any further.
What's happening?
Are we stuck?
Come on!
We're stuck.
Huh?
I wish we'd stayed at the beach to eat my ice pops.
Me too.
We didn't even get to help on the mission.
And I didn't get to finish my tour of the ocean. I'm sorry. I was so determined to rescue the Shimmery Shiny that I forgot about you, my crew.
Helping hand to Mission Control. Looks like you need some help down there. Over.
Captain Mae-Mae to Helping Hand. No help needed. I have this under control, but I need to leave the submarine.
Huh? You're leaving?
Yes, I'm leaving. To rescue my crew and take them back for Plom's delicious ice pops. Stay calm, crew. I'll unstick us. It's no use. It won't budge. No! Stop! Don't eat the submarine! Oh! You're trying to help! You're not a big old meanie at all, are you? Then why did you take my Shimmery Shiny?
Mae-Mae, look behind you.
Huh? It's beautiful! More giant gas!
Actually, they're called clams, a type of shellfish.
And they all have shimmery shiny
pearls.
The pearls belong to the clams. You weren't trying to take it from me, were you? Here, it's yours. At least I know you'll keep it safe. I would love to play with you, Miss Clam. But I promised my crew we'd be back for ice pops. Oh, but I'm not sure how to get back.
This way, everyone!
What amazing fish!
And to your left is the purple-spotted gudgeon fish.
Wow!
Ooh, Phoebe, that's a nice fish, Phoebe.
Goodbye, Miss Clam! And goodbye, Pearl! I won't forget you!
Mission complete! Okay, crew, get ready! It's ice pop time!
Oh, quick! Before they totally melt!
Well, what an adventure! And next time Mae-Mae finds a pearl, well, she won't be so shellfish with it. Get it? Shellfish! Which sounds like selfish. Ah, fun in the sun.